What's going on, guys? Dr. J, MedSchoolInsiders.com. iOS 11 was just released. Let's talk about how to best take notes using the iPad Pro. Stay tuned. This video is brought to you by Quizlet and their new diagrams feature. The iPad Pro is an amazing piece of engineering, but I am not going to go into all the different features. You can look at other videos for that. Here, we're going to go over the optimal ways to use the iPad Pro as a student, such as for taking notes. So here it is. This is the Apple leather sleeve. I have the iPad with the smart keyboard, as well as the Apple Pencil. So let's talk about a few critical features that are going to make your life as a student much easier. If you are taking notes in class and you look something up on your own, let's say you want to take a screenshot of this zygomatic bone because you're studying craniofacial anatomy. You can quickly press the home button and the lock button just like any other iOS device, take a screenshot, and quickly edit, such as crop, and even annotate your image. You can then quickly copy it. If I had the keyboard out, I would just press Command C to copy, or you can go right here, hit copy, return to your note-taking app, and easily paste the image. If you're done with the image, swipe it to the left and it will disappear. Another feature that is new to iOS 11 is the ability to annotate your PDFs within iBooks. So let's say I'm reading about your reconstruction. I press this button up top to enable annotations, and I can then choose from a pen, highlighter, pencil, and eraser to mark up the document. Great thing is, these changes will propagate amongst all your iOS and Apple devices. Multitasking was possible with iOS 10, but in iOS 11, it's even more powerful. Let's say I want to do flashcards, but also reference some other material at the same time. I can swipe up to see the doc, then drag and drop, let's say iBooks, split screen, and quickly reference the material that I want to reference. And again, here I can annotate the document if I wanted to by pressing on this button and drawing as such. Now, a great feature about the iPad Pro with the Apple Pencil is you can seamlessly transition between writing and typing. Let's say I want to create a new note. I can quickly type my notes here and just as easily quickly draw right to the text and then go back to typing, just like that. So next, let's talk about some of the best note-taking applications for iOS 11 on the iPad Pro. I'm a longtime user of Evernote, a huge fan, and I've been using this for several years. Now, this is a note I took on breast reduction, a very important procedure in plastic surgery. And as you can see, I was able to type notes and then draw images that were relevant. But a significant shortcoming with Evernote is that you can't actually draw or insert images seamlessly between text and drawing. So for example, if I want to insert an image, I press this button here, this canvas shows up, and I can draw whatever it is that I want. I hit done, and it inserts the image, but now I can't quickly annotate it or have it draw arrows between the text. That's a common problem on most of these apps. Regardless, this is a very powerful tool, and I think it's going to be great for most people. Next is Apple Notes. Now, I quickly create a new document, I can full screen it, and I can easily type and then draw whatever it is that I need to draw. Again, as with Evernote, you can type and then draw, but not both at the same time. Another neat feature about using Apple Notes is if you turn your screen on but don't unlock it, you can take your Apple Pencil, touch the screen, and a new blank Apple Notes sheet will appear so you can quickly write down whatever notes you need to write. And next is OneNote. This is actually my favorite note-taking app on the iPad Pro as of right now. Here's an example of notes I took on breast reconstruction. And what you can see here is I was able to type on the left-hand side and then seamlessly transition to drawing a breast with incision markings and even reference the text by drawing along the words I've already typed. You can even control where you type, as I've done here, illustrating this is the right breast, not the left breast. Another great feature about using OneNote is you can import a PDF. This is a PDF of a PowerPoint that someone was presenting. And you can easily annotate on this as well. So I've highlighted text I thought that was important, and I've also written right here on the margins. You can even write directly on the slides. This video was sponsored by Quizlet, one of the world's largest student and teacher online learning communities. Quizlet provides engaging, customizable activities with contributions from people all over the world. They are now launching a new feature called Diagrams, and it will be useful for both pre-meds and med students alike. This lets you take an image or one of their diagrams and customize labels and information. This is active learning, something I have emphasized is a key element in effective studying. The cool twist is that you can learn through games and compete with others to work your way up the leaderboard. I've used this myself when reviewing anatomy recently. You can easily organize and share your diagrams with others. This information syncs to your web account, so it is seamless between using the web app on your computer or using their mobile app, which is free, on your iPhone or Android device. To check out Quizlet, create your free account using the link in the description below. You can check out the diagrams feature by browsing diagrams or creating your own content and inserting your own image and adding custom labels. Hope you guys find it useful. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you found this video useful, make sure you press that like button down below. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you guys in that next one.